Hi, this is Madhavi from DBSIT. Now I am going to explain student t-test for difference of means. This is second case of t-test. In this test, we are going to discuss about whether the two sample means are equal or not. We will take two samples from the population. Now we want to test whether the two sample means are equal or not, or we have to test whether the two samples came from the same population or not. These are the two tests: two sample means are equal or not, or two samples are came from the same population. For this, first let us set up H naught. Mu one equal to mu two. Mu one and mu two are two population means. H1, mu1 not equal to mu2, or mu1 greater than mu2, or mu1 less than mu2. So we can take anyone, mu1 not equal to mu2, or mu1 greater than mu2, or mu1 less than mu2. Alpha, 5% or 1%. So this is the null hypothesis H0. First we have to set up H0, mu1 equal to mu2. That means two sample means are equal. First we will take that two sample means are equal. Next we will test whether this statement is accepted or rejected. That is our question. For this, first we have to find S square equal to N1 minus 1 into S1 square plus N2 minus 1 into S2 square by N1 plus N2 minus 2. Or another formula is there. Sigma Xi minus X bar whole square plus sigma Yi minus Y bar whole square by N1 plus N2 minus 2. As per the given data, we can use any formula where N1 equal to first sample size, N2 equal to second sample size, X bar equal to first sample mean, Y bar equal to second sample mean, S1 equal to first sample SD, S2 equal to second sample SD. So first we have to find S square using the given data. Using these two formulas, you can use any formula as per given data. N1 minus 1 into S1 square plus N2 minus 1 into S2 square by N1 plus N2 minus 2. Or sigma xi minus x bar whole square plus sigma yi minus y bar whole square by n1 plus n2 minus 2. So first we will find S square value. After that, we have to find the t value. After finding this S square value, we have to find the t value. T equal to X bar minus Y bar by S into root of 1 by N1 plus 1 by N2. So this is the T formula. The T equal to X bar minus Y bar by S into root of 1 by N1 plus 1 by N2. Next, we have to calculate T value from table. Now we have calculated T value from the formula. After that, we have to calculate T value from the table. For that, let us consider the degrees of freedom equal to N1 plus N2 minus 2. For this case, two samples case, the degrees of freedom is N1 plus N2 minus 2. At this degrees of freedom, we have to calculate T alpha or T alpha by 2 as per one-tailed test or two-tailed test. For one-tailed test, you have to calculate T alpha. For two tailed test, you have to calculate T alpha by 2. If mod T less than T alpha or T alpha by 2, we accept H notch. If mod T greater than T alpha or T alpha by 2, we reject H notch. We can calculate only one value, T alpha or T alpha by 2, as per the H1. As per the taking H1, T alpha or T alpha by 2. So if mod T less than T alpha, we accept H0. If mod T greater than T alpha, we reject H0. So that is the method to test the given hypothesis. Next, we will go for an example. So in this case, the value of t equal to x bar minus y bar by s into root of 1 by n1 plus 1 by n2. So let us go to an example. So first example, samples of two types of electric bulbs were tested for length of life, and the following data was given. So type 1, N1 equal to H, X bar equal to 1234 hours, S1 equal to 36 hours. Type 2, N2 equal to 7, Y bar equal to 1036 hours, S2 equal to 40 hours. Using this data, we have to check whether the two sample means are equal or not. So using this data, we have to check whether the two sample means are, the lengths of the two samples are equal or not. The mean life of two samples, two types of electric bulbs are equal or not. That is the given question. For that, first we will set up H naught. So first we have to set up H naught and H1 and alpha. After that we have to calculate S square, next T value, or next T value from the table. So first we have to set up H naught. So what is the condition we have to check? Whether the two sample means are equal or not. That is the condition we have to check. So let H naught equal to mu 1 equal to mu 2. That means the lengths of the mean life of two types of samples are equal. So first we assume that the mean life of two types of bulbs are equal. Next, H1. Mu 1 not equal to mu 2. Alpha 5%. And the data is given here. First, we have to calculate S square. N1 minus 1 into S1 square plus N2 minus 1 into S2 square by N1 plus N2 minus 2. So now what is N1? We have taken 8 bulbs from first sample and we have taken 7 bulbs from first sample. And the first sample, first type 1 bulbs, mean life is 1234 hours. That means from the first sample, each bulb lifetime is approximately 1234 hours. From the second sample, the life of each bulb is 1036 hours approximately. So that is N1 minus 1, 8 minus 1, into S1 square, 36 square plus 7 minus 1 into S2 square, 40 square over 8 plus 7 minus 2. By calculating this value, 1436.30. So S equal to root of 1436.3, that is equal to 37.89. So that is S value. Next, we have to find T value. So first, set up H naught, H1. H naught means which condition you have to check, that is H naught. H1, alternate hypothesis. Not equal to alpha 5%. Now first find S square. What is the formula? N1 minus S1 square. N1 minus 1 into S1 square plus N2 minus 1 into S2 square over N plus N1 plus N2 minus 2. So by calculating this, S equal to 37.89. Now let us go to the T value. What is T formula? T equal to x bar minus y bar by s into root of x bar minus y bar by s into root of 1 by n1 plus 1 by n2. X bar 1234 minus 1036 over 1 s into. What is s value we have formed? 37.89 times 1 by 8 plus 1 by 7. By calculating this value, we will get 10.09. So, this is the calculated T value from the formula. So, the T value is 10.09 from the formula. Now, we have to calculate T value from the table. First, we have to calculate T value from the formula. After that, we have to calculate from the table. For that, consider the degrees of freedom. N1 plus N2 minus 2, 8 plus 7 minus 2, 13. At 13 degrees of freedom, T alpha by 2, T 0.05 by 2. What is alpha? 5%. That is T 0.025 equal to. This value can be calculated from the P tables. Some 2.145. Now T value is 10.09 and T alpha by 2 is 2.145. So T greater than T alpha by 2. That means, so if T greater than T alpha by 2, then we reject H naught. That means we reject H naught. That means mu1 is equal to mu2 is not correct. The length of the lifetimes of two samples is not equal. We accept H1. So mu1 is not equal to mu2 is correct. So the mean lifetime of two samples is not equal using the given data. So this is the method to test the two sample means are equal or not. Now, let us go to another example. So, for any problem, first we have to set up H0, H1 and alpha. Next, first we have to find S square value from the given data. After that, S value. Next, T value. x bar minus y bar by s into root of 1 by n1 plus 1 by n2. So this is the calculated t value from the formula. After that, you have to find the t value from the table. Here, the t value is 2.145, t is 10.09, t greater than t alpha by 2. So we reject h naught. That means we are rejecting mu 1 equal to mu 2 at 5% level of significance. That means we can say that mu 1 equal to mu 2 is not correct at 5% level of significance. So this is the method to test whether the two sample means are equal or not. Now let us go to another example. Next example. Second example, two horses A and B are tested according to the time in seconds to run a track with the following results. So horse A, horse B. So the data is given in the following table: 28, 30, 32, 33, 29, 34, and 29, 30, 30, 24, 27, 29. Test whether the two horses have the same running capacity. The same running capacity at 5% LOS, level of significance. This is the given question. We are considering two horses A and B. They are running along a particular track. So the time is recorded as follows. To run across the particular track, the time is recorded as follows. So the horse A timings are 28 seconds for first time, 30 seconds for first second time, 32 seconds for third time, 33 seconds for fourth time, 33 seconds for fifth time also, and 29 seconds for sixth time, 34 seconds for seventh time. In the same manner, the time of horse B is also given. For horse B, 29 seconds taken for first time, 30 seconds taken for second time, 30 seconds taken for third time, and so on. So, now the sample is given directly. They are not giving sample mean or sample SD or anything. So, direct sample values are given. So, first you have to calculate sample means and S square and T and everything we have to calculate. First, let us take how many values in first sample. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, the first sample size is 7. How many sample values in the second sample? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, second sample size is 7. So, first let us write the given data. First sample size n1 equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 values. And the first sample equal to 28, 30, 32, 33, 33, 29, 34. Now first find the sample name. So the first sample name. First sample name. X bar equal to, so mean x bar means sum of the elements by number of elements. So 28 plus 30 plus 32 plus 34 by how many values are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So by calculating this, we will get 31.28. Next, first sample variance. Otherwise, we will find sigma xi minus x bar whole square. So, xi means sample value, sample elements, 28, 30, 32, these are the x values. X bar means sample mean, that means 28 minus 31.28 whole square plus 30 minus 31.28 whole square. Plus and so on. So first you have to take each sample value and then subtract sample mean and then whole square. By adding these all terms, 34 minus 31.28 whole square. By adding these all terms, we will get 31.4288. Similarly, take the second sample. What is the second sample size? Second sample size, n2 equal to 6. What are the values in the second sample? Second sample equal to 29, 30, 30, 24, 27, 29. Now we will find second sample mean. Second sample mean y bar equal to sum of the elements by number of elements. 29 plus 30 plus 30, 29 by 6. By calculating all these values, we will get 28.16. Next, we have to calculate sigma yi minus y bar whole square. In the same manner, sigma yi minus y bar whole square, by calculating this value, we will get 26.8336. After this, so first we have taken first sample. So what are the elements of the first sample? 28 30 32 33 33, like this. First sample mean. Mean means sum of the elements by number of elements. Next, sigma xi minus x bar whole square. So take each sample value and subtract x bar and then whole square. Sigma means plus. Next, second value 30 minus x bar whole square. And calculating like this, we will get 31.4288. And then go to the second sample. In the second sample, we have taken 6 values. So, sample size n2 equal to 6. Second sample is 29, 30, 30, 24, like this. Next, second sample make sum of the elements by number of elements. By calculating this, 28.16. And then in the same manner, sigma yi minus y bar whole square. And take each second sample value, subtract y bar and then whole square and add the next ones. So we will get 26.8336. Using these values, we can find S square. Now, must find s square using these values. First find s square. S square equal to sigma xi minus x bar whole square plus sigma yi minus y bar whole square by n1 plus n2 minus 2. So what is sigma xi minus x bar whole square? 31.4288 plus 26.8336 by n1, 7 plus 6 minus 2. By calculating this, 2.302 whole square. So s equal to 2.302. So after finding sample means we have found s square, sigma xi minus x bar whole square plus sigma yi minus y bar whole square by n1 plus n2 minus 2. So by calculating this we will get s equal to 2.302. Now let us set up h naught. Mu1 equal to mu2, h1 mu1 not equal to mu2, alpha 5%. That means we assume that the two horses have the same running capacity. In H1, the running capacity is of not equal for two horses. So which condition is accepted? We will check now. For that, now calculate t value, x bar minus y bar by s into root of 1 by n1 plus 1 by n2. So what is x bar? We have calculated already. 31.28 minus y bar 28.16 by what is s? 2.302 root of 1 by 7 plus 1 by 6. So that is, by calculating all these values, we will get 2.436. So, now the t value is 2.436 from the formula. Next, you have to calculate the t value from the table. Now, we have found t value from the formula. T equal to x bar minus y bar by s into root of 1 by n1 plus 1 by n2. Next, we will go to the table. So, at nu equal to n1 plus n2 minus 2, 8 plus 7 minus, what is n1 and n2? 7 plus 6 minus 2, 11. So at nu equal to 11 degrees of freedom, t alpha by 2, t equal to 1.796. So t value from the formula is 2.436. The t value from the table is 1.796. So t greater than t alpha by 2. That means we reject h naught. So we accept h1. So this is the method to check whether the h naught is accepted or rejected. So first, if the sample values are given, we have to find the sample size and then sample mean for two samples. So first to find x bar and y bar for two samples, and then sigma xi minus x bar whole square and sigma yi minus y bar whole square. Using those values, we will find s square. Sigma xi minus x bar whole square plus sigma yi minus y bar whole square by n1 plus n2 minus 2. So by calculating this value, we will get s equal to 2.302. But our question is whether the two horses have same running capacity or not. For that, set up h0 equal to h0 such that mu1 equal to mu2. That means the two horses have same running capacity. First we will think. H1, mu1 not equal to mu2. So which condition is accepted? We have to check. For that, first find T value from the formula. T equal to x bar minus y bar by s into root of 1 by n1 plus 1 by n2. All the values we know. By substituting all the values and calculating, you will get T value as 2.436. Next, we have to find the T value from the table. For that, we have to consider the degrees of freedom. Mu equal to n1 plus n2 minus 2. So that is 11. So at 11 degrees of freedom, T alpha by 2. Alpha is 5%. Alpha by 2. T 0.025 equal to 1.796. Here T is 2.4. T alpha is 1.7. So T greater than T alpha by 2. That means we reject H naught. We reject H naught. That means we are rejecting that the two horses have same running capacity. So we accept H1. That means the two horses have not same running capacity. There is no running capacity have for two horses. So this is the method for test the two sample means are equal.